Nurses have taken state politicians on ward rounds this week to show them firsthand the problems in the ailing health system. Patients also got the chance to deliver their diagnosis of our public hospitals.
A birthday in hospital's not usually on the wish list, but for breast cancer patient Jennifer Isles, every day's become a celebration. She knows the value of QEH nurses who administer her chemotherapy because staff shortages can mean her treatment takes 2 hours longer than usual.
It takes one staff member to be sick or on holidays, and it's like a deck of cards that sort of falls down.
Those staff had the chance to meet with politicians this week when the Nursing Federation invited them to spend some time on the wards.
I'm still learning, so I'm listening to some of the experts.
And those experts didn't hold back on the areas they thought needed some TLC.
We're having more and more dementia patients, and they're becoming more and more difficult to deal with. Perhaps a bit more support for mental health.
The Federation says it wants more nurses employed now to prepare for the predicted shortage of up to 25,000 nurses and midwives by 2025.
That when we do have the shortage over the next 5 to 10 years, that there will be a workforce.
My job is to make sure that we're adequately resourcing our hospitals, and we do have more nurses per head of population than anywhere else in the country.
Roscoe Whalen, 7 News.